this video, we're going to be taking a look at how to toggle between millimeters and inches using Lightburn. And Lightburn defaults to millimeters. So everything you can see here, the width and height, the grid lines along here, they've all got metric measurements there. And even in the library, if you go into there, if you've got anything in there, you can see that's all in millimeters as well. So in order to change to inches, it's pretty simple. You can see I've got this square on the screen and I want this to be 5 by 7 inches. So all I need to do is come up here, you'll see this little option, and if you don't actually see that there, what it probably means is your window is just not stretched out enough. You notice as I drag it down, it disappears. You'll see this little double arrow. If you click on that, you'll see it there. But otherwise, if you just keep your window open a little wider, that's fine. You should see it then. I'll just do that a bit more. There it is again. So all I need to do now is click on it. Changes to inches, and you'll notice everything has changed. All these options are in inches, the grid line measurements here in inches, and even our library, they're all in inches now as well. So now I can just change my width. I can go 5 by 7, it's already 7, so that's fine. And now it's changed, and I can easily just toggle back now to millimeters. Now you can also change from millimeters to inches up in the settings here. So if I click on it, we'll get this pop up here, and you'll notice this section here, the units and grids section, and it'll depend on what sort of laser you're using. If you're using a CO2, you need to choose the best option there. I use diode laser, that's what we've got. So we use millimeters per minute. Now you can change it to inches per minute, and I'm going to click there, and you'll notice as I do that, keep an eye up here. But when I click on OK, you'll see that changes now to inches. Everything's changed there, including the library here. Now this will also change our speed and power settings. If I double click on it, you can see now it says speed inches per minute. Now I really like using millimeters per minute, but I also like using inches over here for my measurements. So how do we get around that? So I'll just click OK to get out of there. We come back to the settings. And you'll see this third option down here, inches per millimeter minute. Okay, so basically what it's saying, it's going to use inches for making the measurements, but it's going to use the millimeters per minute for the speed and power. So I'll show you what that means. I'll select it, and again, we'll go OK. So up here now, we'll have inches for our measurements, but over here, we'll have millimeters per minute. So that's exactly what I'm after. So you can choose the best option for you. For me, it's millimeters per minute over here. But for here in the settings, I like using inches. So hopefully that was helpful. If it is, please give us a thumbs up. It really does help our channel. And thank you for watching.